Providing women and girls with equal access to education is not only a fundamental human right, but a necessary foundation for a prosperous and sustainable world. While the world has achieved progress towards gender equality and women's empowerment under the Millennium Development Goals, including equal access to primary education between girls and boys, women and girls continue in every discrimination and violence in every part of the world, and Nigeria is not an exception. As girls move into adolescence, gender disparities widen. The disparity is often seen in rural areas where poverty is the obstacle for children not going to school, and a choice has to be made between siblings, either the boy goes or the girl. This explains the 2015 Nigeria Education Data Survey that pegs the number of rural females without any form of schooling in the country at 49%, and the net enrollment of females in secondary schools at 45.1%.
When I graduated from my primary school, my parents did not have the money to put me in secondary school, but by the help of this UNPA, they helped me, they now put me in school and they are paying my school fees.
By keeping girls out of school, we disenfranchise them of the skills needed to contribute meaningfully in the labor market. We increase the possibility of them becoming child brides and limit their potentials to be everything they can and ought to be.
The girl was just one. Auburn. Yes.
Ada ina talle safi ingina rana ingina yamma amma yanzu na daina yi saboda zuwa ingina feden an da an sa mana rana amma yanzu an tira rana yanzu muna zuwa safe space din suna biya mana littafi suna ba biya mana kudin makaranta suna ba mu littafai kuma yanzu ina so in cin maburi na in zama doctor.
UNFPA, the United Nations Population Fund, in partnership with CEDA, the Canadian International Development Agency, and PRHI, is reducing these risks by expanding the possibility of adolescent girls to stay in school through the Adolescent Girls Initiative.
The Adolescent Girl Initiative is UNFPA's response to the challenges we identified to adolescent girls reaching their full potential, especially in northern Nigeria. So it's an initiative where girls are supported to stay in school and to exercise their human rights in terms of accessing health interventions, education, and also capacity building.
We enroll girls from primary school into secondary school and ensure that there is retention and completion of secondary education. And this has gone a long way in delaying the age of marriage for girls. And it has helped them to be able to better help themselves in all aspects of their life.
But beyond what they learn in school, beyond the walls of the classroom, is the need to understand their sexual and reproductive health.
And a woman's monthly bleed.
We normally treat life skill with them, then reproductive health issue, followed by literacy.
When we started with the girls didn't have confidence in themselves. They are so shy to narrate personal things that are really happening in their life, even to their mothers.
Improving access to quality education for all is critical to all areas of a healthy society, including poverty reduction.
Ina fatan inda ni ban yi makaranta ba saboda haka shi yasa na dage yanzu akan iyalai na su yi makaranta saboda ina son makarantar nan shi zai kawo ci gaban da za a samu likita a cikin su ko da wani abu ya tashi za a ce anguwana da likita ga yarinya na can tana yi shine abun alfahari na
ana ta magana yaya mata ne har wasu suna kushi cewa wai yaya ne sai yaya mata yaya mata muke ga musu a to an kuka lura ai yaya mata sun fi kasa da yaya maza a wajen karatu tun da yanzu an lissafi yaya mazan wanda suka samu suka karatu ai gasha su ma suna karantarwa to kuma ba mu da wata yaya mace wanda take zuwa karantarwa yayin zuma akan jin dadi game da yaya wanda suke tallama mu ba su.
If you're a girl, you can make these universal goals achievable by staying in school and fighting for your rights to access sexual and reproductive health services. If you're a woman, you can address unconscious biases and implicit associations that can form an unintended and often an invisible barrier to equal opportunity. If you are a man or a boy, you can work alongside women and girls to achieve gender equality and embrace healthy, respectful relationships. If you are a donor, you can fund education campaigns such as the Adolescent Girls Initiative to ensure that every woman and girl fulfills her full potential.